Hello everyone, good morning. Today we will discuss about the Arrhenius equation, that is an equation relating the temperature and reaction rate. So the Arrhenius equation is given as, mathematically it is K equal to A into E to the power minus EA by RT, where K is the rate constant, that is the rate constant, A is the Arrhenius constant, so A is the Arrhenius constant, EA is the activation energy, that is the activation energy, activation energy. R is the universal gas constant, universal gas constant, and its value is 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin. And T is the temperature, that should be in Kelvin scale. Now, so basically this is the Arrhenius equation. K is very small when the activation energy is very large, and the activation energy is very large, then the rate constant will be very small, or the rate of the reaction will be very slow. Okay, now we can also take the log from both the sides, and we can write it at like ln k equal to ln a plus, that is minus, activation energy by R into T. So suppose if this is y, this is C, and this will be equal to mx. So if we just plot a graph of, ln k versus 1 by t, then it will be a straight line like this. So this is ln k and this is 1 by t. So here the slope is minus E A by R, the slope will be minus E A by R, and that slope is negative, and the intercept is ln A, so slope is negative, so the graph will be like this. This will be the slope, m equal to tan of theta and equal to minus E A by R, and where the intercept is ln A. So this distance from this to this is the intercept, and this is ln A, that is the graph. So you can say plot versus ln k is, and 1 by t will be a straight line whose slope will be equal to minus E A by R, and whose intercept with the ordinate is ln A. So that is all about the Arrhenius equation. Now let's solve a problem that is based on this. Question is, what activation energy should a reaction have so that raising the temperature by 10 degree centigrade at 0 degree centigrade would triple the reaction rate? So initial rate of the reaction, initial temperature of the reaction is 0 degree centigrade. And suppose rate is R1, when we are increasing 10 degree centigrade temperature, then rate become 3R1, like thrice of the initial one. Okay, so we can just write the reaction, write the solution. We know the Arrhenius equation is K equal to A into e to the power minus ea by rt. Okay, so we can also write ln k equal to ln a minus ea by rt. Okay, suppose at initial that is at 0 degree centigrade, we can write as ln k equal to ln a minus activation energy by r into temperature that is 0 degree centigrade, so we have to put in Kelvin, and that is 273 Kelvin. Now this is equation number 1. At 10 degree centigrade, we are increasing the temperature by 10 degree centigrade, so now it will be in Kelvin, the temperature final will be 273 plus 10, that is 283 Kelvin. Now for that again we can write the same reaction, but here it will be ln, and now it will be not k because the reaction rate is thrice of the initial one, because it is tripling the reaction rate, so it will be 3k. Okay, now there will be no change in a, so it will be again ln a minus activation energy by r into temperature, now it will be 283. That is equation number 2. We have two equations, okay, and we have to solve for activation energy. Okay, now just expand this equation number 2, we can write ln 3 plus ln k equal to ln a minus ea by 283 r. Okay, now we can just remove this ln a by putting ln a equal to ln k plus this one. Here we can write, from this equation we can write ln a equal to ln k plus ea by 273 r, and we can put this ln a into this place, then what will happen, let's write here, it will be ln 3 plus ln k. Now ln a is equal to ln k plus activation energy by 273 r, and that will be negative ea by 283 r. Now ln k will be cancelled out. Now activation energy will be equal to, you just take the common here, it will be ln 3 divided by 1 upon 273 r minus 1 upon 283 r. And if you put all the values, like ln 3 is 1.10, okay, and the r value is 8.314, okay, if you put all the values, we will get the activation energy as 7.07 into 10 is to 4 joule per mole. That is the activation energy that we will get after solving this. So that is the end of this lecture. Thank you.